Every time I move, I lose. When I look, I'm in. And every time I turn around, I'm back in love again.
Well, this is like the heart that we kind of, it came in to our graphics on the album before this. Something in Love, it was a heart with rings around it. Right. So
that's Jake Riley of LTD meeting with the group's fans at a record shop and talking about the cover of the LTD album Togetherness.
You know, each one of these, they're griffins, actually. It's supposed to be made of glass.
I see the crystal in it. Right. I see the crystal glass. You know, it's very elegant. Very, very elegant. Very elegant. It's beautiful. I see the crystal. It has beauty into it.
This is a city. You know,
I can tell you.
Different little things. Basketball court.
People.
Right.
People. Yeah. A world of beauty. Yeah. Right. A crystal beauty. God's creation.
Right.
Yeah, it's pretty. It's pretty, I can tell.
There's nothing prettier to LTD than the success they've got now. Now, after 10 years of traveling, recording, getting their sound together, and getting the name LTD known to fans everywhere.
Hey, how do you and the group get along together?
We get along together fine. Sometimes we argue, you know, of course, like it's a family, you know. We have arguments like, you know, you and your sister or you and your mother might have an argument, but we work it out, you know, work it out.
What instrument do you play?
I play trombone.
Trombone? Is that the only one?
I play other instruments, but I just play trombone in the group. I play piano, bass.
I'd like to find out, how did you get started with the group?
How did I get started with the group? I kind of helped form the group with four more other people, you know, so it's... We were working with Sam and Dave and Johnny Taylor as backup musicians, you know, and we decided to go on our own, you know, about the time Sly hit, you know, self-contained groups, you know, so we decided to form our group, you know, and get...
How long have you been together?
10 years.
Yeah.
I'm Jim Maddox, and this hour is LTD's Hour. It started as a dream, and it's become an amazing story of 10 men sharing their lives, a 57 Chevrolet, and a lot of music.
Most people really don't know my name unless they come to the concerts, and we're just now getting to the point where we're being able to play these large concerts and people are coming and knowing my name.
His name is Jeff Osborne.
Most people,
and
a lot
people
of
are getting to know him because of the vocals he does for LTD.
Most people, a lot of people don't even read the back of album covers. You know, they buy the album, they sit down, listen to it, and that's it. And that's how they refer to someone as the lead, you know, the lead singer with LTD. So it doesn't bother me at all. It's amazing that they're starting to recognize me now on the streets. Hey, you're the lead singer with LTD. Holding on.
Oh, gonna hold it on. It's very hard to deal when love's gone, and that's love. Hold it on. It's very hard to deal when love's gone. Yeah,
yeah.
I know you gotta be.
I go out your mind. There ain't no sense in crying. It's not for you to be.
It's not for you to be.
That's the bottom line.
Said I'm holding on.
Love is in so many LTD songs. The letters LTD mean love, togetherness, and devotion. And it's not just a slogan, but a way of life. And as I said, it all started as a dream. The dreamer was Jimmy Davis. They call him JD.
I was really waiting for a group like this because I had a dream and a sound in my head of a group, you know, big group like this with a lot of horns and a full rhythm section, you know, and I could write and arrange and just do my thing musically the way I wanted to. And it hadn't come along, so I was just sitting there waiting, and when they came to me with it, I was ready for it.
JD wasn't the only one who was ready.
Our first album had a song on it called Success, you know, and it was had a good message in it, you know, and I think it really was aimed at us. You know, I think it was a lesson that we had to learn by listening to the song. The song became a hit with us.
That's Billy Osborne, you know, really Jeffrey's brother. Billy shares vocals, keyboards, and percussion.
Because now we're starting to get a little success, you know. Mm. And part of one of the lines was, if that's all you want, then I want it for you, and I'll do my best to get you some if it's the last thing I do. But we've worked hard for it now, and we've learned a lesson from them songs. And you don't plan to write those songs. Like, the song Make Someone Smile on the last album, you don't plan those songs. You know, you sit down, you write a song, and you don't say, well, I'm going to make this lyric spiritual, I'm going to make these chords spiritual or something like that. Doesn't happen like that, man. It's in there, and it comes out. You know, it just comes out naturally. It comes out of us. It's some of the things that we want to let the people know about how we feel about it. We want the people to look at us and say, hey, they stand for something more than just getting on the stage, humping and grinding and taking our money. They are trying to give us a message.
Billy's song, Together Forever, on the new album, could be another good theme song for LTD.
Forever.
first name we had was Love Men Limited, Love Men LTD. We added a girl, and it just became Love LTD. Then it evolved because of so many love groups, you know, Love and Love Limited and Love Unlimited and all that. So we just decided to call it LTD and put periods, and it stood for Love, Togetherness, and Devotion, which is really sort of the way we live.
Get ready for a long drive. We're going to follow Love Men Limited from Greensboro, North Carolina, to New York City in a 57 Chevy. That's next on LTD Togetherness.
We formed a group in Greensboro, North Carolina. We played a couple of clubs and made a dollar or two, you know. Got some gas money to go to New York in the 57 Chevy that you heard about.
It's 1968 again, and we're driving from North Carolina to New York. After all, that's where the big money is, right? You can't make a dime in Greensboro. But even for 1968, this car is old. A 1957 Chevrolet.
By the time we went to New York, we had progressed a bit, and I think the Chevy was just about on its last legs, and it finally got parked on a side street in New York. But
it was the first investment that we made together as a group. The Chevy just meant, you know, a lot to us because we all bought it together.
They call that guy Onion. Abraham Miller's his real name.
I knew J.D. from Greensboro because he had the best band in town. They were a jazz band. Of course, I didn't know him very personally then. When I came off the road, I got a chance to know him. And we had decided, you know, to leave Sam and Dave and get this together. So when we did, we just started, you know, got him in the group and started involving him and trying to get him to leave Greensboro and go on the road, travel with us. And that led to LTD, and I've been here ever since.
That's the story for several LTD members, Onion, Jake, Lorenzo Carnegie, and Carl Vickers. They were with Sam and Dave's band in the mid-60s. But they were looking for a chance to do music of their own.
You guys are the best reproducers I've ever heard.
Right.
You
know? Carl Vickers from the LTD horn section.
He says it sounds just like Sly and the Family Stone. I couldn't believe it.
He knew that was a compliment. But playing other people's music was not what the group wanted. They wanted a chance to be real.
Yeah.
time to drive again. If the East Coast is not the answer for LTD, it's time to head west.
We wanted to do our own thing, but we knew that we had to play this top 40 music in order to survive, you know, so we had to do something. So we picked up Jeff in Providence and made him drive to Los Angeles.
Jeff's greatest talent at the time was that he had a driver's license.
Good driving chops.
LTD knew what else he could do. They'd heard him sing, and they'd seen his work behind a drum kit. But thanks to his driver's license, he was on his way to Hollywood to be a star.
This was the first time I left Providence. I've been living there 21 years. I told my mother I was going out to be a star. Get to California, and we stay in a hotel room. And the next day, Onion comes in and says, okay, everybody, it's time to call home for some money. I said, I can't do that. I have too much pride. You know, I can't call home and say, Ma, I need some money. 2 days been out here. Got to do it. We're going to get put out the hotel. So I finally called my brother. He was in Texas, and borrowed some money from him. I still owe him that $75, too.
It's just like the LTD song. If you're in need, just pick up the telephone.
Sometimes things lay kind of heavy, heavy on your mind, and there are some answers to problems that we all need to find. If you're in need sometime, I wanna be with you, so don't hesitate. Our lives are both the same, but the truth just doesn't change. We're both need happiness, so give yourself a chance. Loving you another man. If you're in need some time, just pick up the telephone. If you're in need some time, ain't no reason to be alone. If you're in need some time, I understand what you're going through. I've been through a change or two. I'm happy people, they're just a few. And I'm here to do what I can do for you. All things come to pass, why should you tear yourself down? Love doesn't always last, but there'll still be plenty around.
What we used to get the apartment with?
The money.
Mm-hmm. Where we got the money from?
Our first gig.
Well, after hours from 1 to 6 in the morning behind a female impersonator.
That's right.
For $100. That's the pits.
Sometimes we forget that becoming a star means paying a lot of dues and going to every audition in town.
Bill Cosby was
financially backing Operation Breadbasket they would have every Saturday morning. So that gig saved us. We would play Saturday morning from like 9 to 12, 3 hours, just once that weekend. And that was at least $300 for the group coming in that weekend. That would pay rents on apartments that we had.
You can tell that the group's evolution was taking place slowly, but surely. J.D., Carl, Onion, Lorenzo, and Jake had been joined by Jeffrey. Now, add Henry Davis, a bass man and flute player from Los Angeles.
It was the opportunity to be in a group, you know, a big group. I had five horns to work with. I could learn how to write. I could learn a lot from the different people in the band about playing, you know. And it was really something that I really wanted to get into, and I believed in the dream that they had. And if it hadn't been for, you know, joining this band, I wouldn't have been in the position, say, like, to become a pretty popular studio musician. And so I could play the Motown sessions. Then I can go over and play a Bobby Goldsboro session or a Barbra Streisand session, you know. And I've even done a Hillbilly session, you know, things like that.
When? Tonight? Fine, yeah. I'll be there in the morning.
John McGee had known Henry from recording sessions in Los Angeles, and LTD had been after him for a year to join the group. He had no idea that this was the phone call.
So I came on down, learned the tunes, and played the demo date. And I don't know, it was happening. It was just happening immediately. You know, you don't find that very often, where you can just go into a situation and sit down and play, and it's just there, all gels. I don't know. It was like I was supposed to have been there all along.
It's that feeling, that commitment to the dream that keeps LTD together. Next, we'll get to know the individual members of the group and how they make their dream work.